Hello and welcome to my reaction to episode 7 of Now and Then, Here and There. Last episode was pretty cool. Well, was pretty good on a narrative standpoint. Otherwise, it was pretty fucked up. The army going to conscript more kid, abducting women, and then we got the reveal that after they do that, they raised the fire missile on the rest of the village, killing everybody, which means that the hope that all those kids have in serving in the army and one day going back home is not true because everyone is dead. That's been revealed now. Sarah finally escaped, well, which is fucking great. And as I said, I think she's become my favorite character now. She's definitely the most interesting and the one I most look forward to seeing where she's gonna go. I'm expecting maybe some kind of resistance, but we'll see. So, episode 7. Let's get into this. In 3, 2, 1. Oh yeah, and the main character is probably going to be court-martialed. Okay. There's a mountain of problem indeed. I really like this song. Pretty cool opening song. In a sense, he deserves it. In the sense that in his situation, he should try to cooperate as much as he could. And what he tried to do was clearly not gonna, was not done in a smart way, and was clearly gonna end up fucking him up. Obviously, the situation is fucked up in general, so he doesn't deserve it on that ground, but on the ground that in his situation, if he wants to help, you should try to cooperate and not get killed, I guess. Is he in the latrine? Is he in the shitter? course. I may be wrong. That girl. They didn't capture her again. Okay. I guess Shu never learned the fact that Sarah was raped. Yeah, it's shit, right? Terrible. Move. Can you imagine how much the smell then? This reminds me a bit of Jesse from Breaking Bad, the place he's in at the end of the final season. Not gonna say much more, but you know what I mean. There was no shit involved, but it reminded me of that, looking up and shit. Oh shit, the pendant is there. How fucking convenient. Holy shit. Ugh. This is the kind of thing that no way now, if this was real life, he wouldn't catch disease and fucking die quick. Okay, I was going to say, what about the pendant? Not impressed. Can you finally kick this shit, the shit out of this guy? He's obviously not gonna kill him, but beat the shit out of him. Come on, do it. That's it. Oh my god. Once again, the main character is absolutely retarded. Absolutely retarded. Obviously, actually knocking him out was the smart thing here, if you don't want to kill him. But no. This is a bit infuriating. I've seen many characters like that throughout my year of watching anime, but this is still as annoying as ever. It's gonna get catched again. There's no way. Taboo is probably going to hit. Be quiet, you fucking idiot. So did he actually stab her in the eye? Or is it his blood? Okay, it was his blood. Oh shit. But is that really that easy? Of course, there's an unbreakable glass. Maybe not unbreakable, I guess. Once again, I can't believe he's gonna manage to escape after this. Why are you just sitting? Why is this so dumb? come on. I can't be the only one getting pissed off at this. This is so dumb. This is terrible. Seriously. I was trying to hold myself from saying it, but this is absolute trash. I was enjoying this show, and it already did that a couple of times, but this is so dumb now. Why wouldn't you run? Why did you just sit in the fucking... I'm still gonna hope. Maybe the show can get good again, but this is so dumb. Okay, that's good. Okay, I'm gonna hold back for after the episode is over to explain what I think is the problem with this. But I think it's pretty obvious. I mean, I'm fine with this, Lalaru using a power like that. I'll explain after one. Definitely wasn't expecting the escape to be that early on. Using a power, I guess. Is he gonna let him go? Go on, talk loud, scream. This is one of the big problems with this show. that. They finally swayed. Nah, not yet. Okay, debt repaid. Definitely gonna see each other again. Hopefully they can coincidentally meet with Sarah. Okay, so here I go. Basically, what really pisses me off is that at this point, the main character shouldn't be that retarded. At the beginning of the show, he was just a normal kid in the real world, so it made sense that he was not worldly, he was not. He was dumb, basically. It made sense, you could say. But it's been 7 episodes, a lot has happened to him, a lot that easily should be something that he learned. And still, there's a scene where he's absolutely retarded. Like, he's undetected, this is night. He run into someone, he get the first move, and what does he do? It doesn't knock him out, it just let him scream and alert everyone and get himself in a worse situation. You know, when he was dumb at the beginning of the show, as I've said, it wasn't that big of a deal to me because I could pass it off that it makes sense, it's just a normal kid from the real world. But now, he's been through so many since so much shit, he should have smartened up a bit. I don't like how he's still as retarded as before. And the worst part was definitely when he just sat on the couch. That was really, really dumb, and it did not make any damn sense. Obviously, what happened is that she used her power, and that's what saved them, but in the context of the situation, even as retarded as it can be, the obvious choice is to try to run with her. But nope, he just sit there like a fucking idiot. Everyone is looking for him, and he just sit there. I mean, yeah, I do anime reactions, so of course I get pissed off about anime, probably more than I should, but that's just how it is. Anime is my life at this point. I've watched way too much, probably. So yeah, things like that piss me off. I can't believe he's still that dumb. I mean, you people should agree with me on this, right? There's no way he should still be that dumb. At the beginning, it made sense and was forgivable, but there is no character chance. You'd think after all of this, seeing people die, seeing fucked up shit, being tortured, everything like that, it should change him a bit, make him smarten up. Nope. It's really, I think the problem with this show is it's sometimes it's trying to be Ghibli, a Ghibli movie, with the action, which are, you know, like, really dumb action, like jumping from something that's falling to something else, that kind of stuff. And then sometimes trying to be a more serious show with stuff like rape and murder and child soldier. And yeah, like the main character is basically a Ghibli main character in a fucked up show, I guess, is a way to describe it. Anyway, I guess I got a bit more pissed off than I should have. But as I said, this is my life. This is what I do. I watch anime and get pissed off at it. Or just enjoy it so much I can't believe it. But anyway, hopefully I was clear enough about why I got pissed off. I still enjoy the show. I still hope there is good to come. Yeah. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.